Hello everybody, welcome to this instruction video. In this video I'd like to show you how to make the Celtic knot square that's been designed by Tatiana from Little Bjorn Crochet. This square is part of a blanket pattern. In this video I'll show you how to make the square. For the joining instructions and the rest of the blanket pattern, I'd like to refer you to the written description. Post a link in the description of this video to the full pattern. To make this square, I'm using Scheepjes Stonewashed XL yarn. This yarn, and I'm using it in combination with a 5mm crochet hook. I'll take you step by step through the rows that make up this pattern. I want to thank you for watching, and I hope it's a useful video for you. Row 1, I'm going to start by making a slip knot and putting this on my hook. Now chain 38 and keep these chains just a little bit on the loose side, because if you make these too tight your square is also going to be tight. If you find it difficult to keep this just a little loose, consider going up a hook size for your chains, because this will be the bottom side of your square. I'm just going to chain 38. 38 chain stitches. We're now going to come back and in the third chain from the hook, going to start working double crochet stitches. Now these first two, so we're going to skip the first one, that's this one and the next one. Then in the third chain stitch from the hook, work your first double crochet. And I'm actually going to just turn it around and work in the back here, in the spine of the chain. If you look here at the chain, you see these V's. This is kind of the front side. You turn it over, you'll see here this little loop here on the back. I'm just going to work into those stitches, because then you're going to have that nice V at the bottom of your work. So in the third chain from the hook, work a double crochet. And these first two chain stitches that you're skipping, they do not count as a stitch. And then you work a double crochet on every stitch, every chain stitch. And it's going to be 36 in total. And I'm just splitting my yarn here. Oh, there we go. So I'm just going to work a double crochet on every stitch for row one. That's 36 double crochets when you get to the last stitch. See, I've now have a few already. See, and these chain two here at the beginning, they don't count as a stitch, so that they're is your first stitch. Continue, work a double crochet on every stitch, and I'll see you for row two. Row two, got all these stitches here. We're now going to do chain one, turn your work, turn it the other way, and now work a single crochet on every stitch. Now that chain one doesn't count as a stitch. That means here, this first one is where you already need to make your single crochet, the very first stitch. And that's the first one of 36, going to do 36 single crochets. Especially for row two, just count your stitches, because if you've got 36 here, then you know your base is right and you can take it from there. So work a single crochet on every stitch until you get to the other side. Just working the last stitches. Now what's important here, I now have only two stitches left. You see those two there? That chain two from the beginning, from turning, those two chain stitches, they're not going to work into that, only in those two stitches themselves. So don't work in your turning chain two, only in the last stitch. You see there are the two stitches that are from turning. You don't work in those. So this should be stitch number 36. So just take a moment to just count your stitches to make sure you've got 36 stitches, and then you're good to go. Row 3. You can start with a chain 2, which is not a stitch. Turn your work. Then that means the very first stitch, that's going to be that one that I'm opening there, you need to work in there your first double crochet, that first stitch. and then work a double crochet on every stitch till you get to the other side. That's going to be 36 in total. You're going to have 36 stitches for each row. So work a stitch on each row and work a double crochet on each stitch, 36 in total. And this chain two here at the beginning, that does not count as a stitch. Row four, chain one, and turn your work. Now we're going to start the first real pattern row. In the first stitch, work a single crochet. I'm going to work three, so that's one, two, and three single crochets. Now we're going to work a front post treble around the sixth single crochet from row two, from two rows down. If you just see, the previous row was these double crochets, so you're going for the single crochet row. That's this row here, because you see here are the doubles and the singles. So you need number six. So if all else fails, just count. So that's one, two, three, four, five, six. This is the single crochet you're going for. You're going to make a front post treble around that stitch. And this is going to be a long stitch. You're really going to have to do this diagonal here. So remember, double crochet is once, treble is twice over. Now you've just, I held my finger on the position, on the stitch I'm going for, so that way I can't forget. So just check. That's one, two, three, four, five, six. This is the stitch we're going for. Do a front post treble around that stitch, so twice over. This is the stitch I'm going for. Then around that stitch, pick up your yarn. And now we're going to complete the treble, and it's important to give this treble enough room that you don't pull your fabric in, because you want everything to align at the top. So I'm just going to work the treble, so that's once, twice, three times. And what you want is that this here lines up. You don't want this stitch to kind of stop here, that your fabric really pulls inward. You want this to be one line with the stitches you already have. This was your first treble. You're going to do two more, so twice over, and then the next stitch, so this was a stitch I just had, and then on the next single crochet, next to that work another treble. Again, take off once, twice, three times. You see how your stitches are still in line here at the top. Then a third time, twice over, and on the next stitch, work another treble. That's one, two, three. If I put my work flat, you see that line there is continuing. You don't want this to kind of dip inwards or actually be much too loose, that you've got this bulb there. So you really want that line straight. We're now going to skip three stitches here to the back, because these three stitches are really, they take that position. So if you look back to where you were last, you see this is the stitch that you last worked that last single crochet in. That means you're going to skip one, that, two, three stitches, and this is going to be the next one you work in. So that stitch there. I've got my yarn on the wrong side, of course. So that was the last stitch worked. The single crochet, then skip one, two, three stitches, and then stitch number four here, work the first single crochet. That's one, two, you need to do three single crochets. We're now going to come back down and work another set of three trebles. And the first treble is going to be around the same single crochet below. So we already have these ones here. We're going to do that there again. So that means this stitch here, we you have this front post treble around that same stitch, there you're going to do another front post treble and on the next stitch. And do take note, we're only going to do two trebles now, because here you did three, but on the inside of the square we're only going to do two. So take note of that. So it's twice over. So that means in that position you already have the trebles. In the same one, you're really going to have to fold your work to kind of get around that stitch. So this is the same stitch that contains that last treble that we already made. And then take off one, two, three times. So you can see this, the stitches has, this one now has two trebles in it. The next stitch, another treble, so right next to it, twice over. So the stitch next to it, that's going to be this one here. You can see how you've worked those two trebles. And your work will kind of pull a little bit inward at this point, don't worry about that. As the square gets bigger, this will relax more. Going to skip two stitches to the back. And see, that's the last single crochet work, so I'm just going to skip one, two stitches, because you've now made two trebles, you're going to skip two stitches, and here in the third stitch, work a single crochet. And this is your first part of the cable made. So that's a one single crochet, you're actually going to make 14. So that was number one, two, three, 13, and this is number 14. So I've now done 14 single crochets since this last cable there. So here on this last stretch, we're now going to work basically the same as on this side here, but in reverse, but in mirror image. So here we're first going to work two front post trebles, three singles, and then another three front post trebles, and then the last stitches. Our next stitch is a front post treble, again around the stitches from two rows down. And those are these single crochets here. Now we're going to need number nine. So this here's number, so you're just going to have to count your stitches. So this here is a, your first stitch, that one there. Let me just get it into view. This is your first one, so that's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. This here is stitch number nine, and that one there. That's the one that we're going to be using. Let me just double check that, that's correct. So it is one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Yes, that's number nine. So I'm going to make a front post treble around that stitch. And I'm purposefully marking it because this is you know, when you've counted and then you do the double and then you somehow forget the position. So I'm purposefully just leaving my needle in there. So I'm going to do twice over. Then around the post of that stitch, I can actually remove the needle. I'm going to do a front post treble. And give these stitches room to breathe. So really make this stitch long enough that you really get back to where you're currently at. That was the one. Going to do a second one in a stitch next to it. So that's here, around that stitch there. Going to do your next front post treble. It's twice over. Pick up. One, two, three. Going to skip two stitches to the back again. Exactly the same as before. You see I'm skipping those two stitches. This is the first of three, so that's one, two, three single crochets. And now we're going to come back down and work again three trebles. And the first treble is going to be around the same position as the last one we made. So again, around that same stitch there. Going to work a treble. That's twice over. You're going to have to fold your work to really get around that stitch. And then complete the treble. twice over because you're going to do two more in the stitch next to it. Do one. And also the stitch after that. All these are on stitches from row two. Like so, and that, you can see how you have that, these cables here now. I just skip three stitches from the back. Just check, oh, I need to skip one more. You can see that's the last stitch worked, that one there. You can see there's a single crochet in there. And you're going to skip one, two, three stitches. And then here number four is going to be the next one. And you should at this point have three single stitches left. You're going to work a single crochet on those. So that's one, two, and here's number three. That's the last stitch. Because you see there's your turning stitches. Those turning chains, you don't work on that. So this is stitch number three. That's the last one. And at this point, let me just zoom out a little bit. What's important is that you have these stitches correct. If this is correct, it's really going to help you with the rest also. So make sure that your stitch count is correct. You've got 36 stitches at this point, and that your cables here are symmetric. So you've got two and then three on the outside, 14 single crochets in the middle, and if your square looks like this at this point, you're good to go. Row five. It's the same as row three. I'm going to work a double crochet in every stitch. But I'd just like to show you how to treat these spaces you've got there, because you'll have pockets behind the stitches that you skipped. So these trebles here, you're going to have these little pockets, and they're going to stay there unless you do something about that. So let me just show you. To do chain two, this is not a stitch, this is just a turn, to turn your work. And now we're going to work a double crochet on every stitch. I'm just going to work the first few, three stitches, that's one, two, and three. Now your next stitch is the treble. You see there, that's the treble, that's your next stitch. And that also corresponds with these three skipped stitches. Now if I was just to continue working my double crochets, which you can do, there's absolutely nothing wrong with doing this. You just continue with these double crochets, and the pattern was going to build and build, and then you're going to have these pockets here. You see those spaces, and you might find that a bother. So what to do about that? I'm just going to undo those last three stitches. So I'm going to just connect this to my work. So I've worked those first three double crochets. Now this is the pocket stitch. See that those are the skip stitches. I'm going to just hook up the back loop and go through the stitch that I want to work. So I've got three loops on my hook. The first, the front two is from the treble. That's actually the stitch that we're working. And I'm just hooking that loop, the back loop of those skipped stitches. And then I'm going to, and that connects everything together. So I'm going to do that again with the next one, because you've got three of these here next. All in a row. The next loop and the full stitch. And let's do that again. With a double crochet and the last one here. That's this loop and the stitch. And work a double crochet. See, and this way, this pocket now, that pocket is gone. It's not there anymore. You have one here also. I'm going to do the same there. I'm going to do the same on this side. So that way I'm going to connect everything together, so you don't have any of those pockets. And the next stitches is just just normal stitches, because these are just the single crochets that you made between the trebles. I don't know if you can hear that in the background. That's my cat snoring. Sorry about that. And the next stitch is again a skipped stitch, so you're going to grab the back loop of that, and the next stitch is going to be a treble, and then just hook them all together, and the next stitch also, and especially the last one is always just a little hard. You're going to have to kind of dig for that back loop. Can you see how now you've got this smooth background here? You now don't have those open pockets anymore. And now a double crochet on every stitch until I get to the next cable, where I'm going to be doing exactly the same. And this row that we're doing now, it's a repetition of row 3, it's a row of double crochet stitches. I'm going to do this between the pattern rows. So what I'm also going to do is I'm going to show you all the pattern rows, and then this row where you just work a row of double crochets, I will not show you. I'll tell you to do it, but I'll not show it to you, because at a certain point I'm sure that you can work a row of double crochets. That's why I'm just spending time showing you this row now, and then after each pattern row, repeat this. We're on to the next place where there are pockets again. You can see here those two skipped stitches. So I'm just going to hook up that back loop and go through the next stitch. Do it also for the stitch after. So that one there and the stitch. Three more double crochets to do here. So it's one, two, three. And then on the last, you've got here three trebles. Just gonna hook those up also. Let me just see, either that first one here is just a little bit hidden. You're often gonna have to just dig for the ones that are on the edges. This is number two. And then this is number three. And I just need to, yes. Hook that up, and at this point I have three stitches left. Going to work a double crochet on those also. Count your stitches, you should have 36 at this point. If it makes you just less stressful, just count your stitches. And that's the last one. You see there's a turning chain, you don't work that, you never work the turning chains. So that completes row 5. If I just bring it forward. This is what your pattern looks like at the moment. You're going to be building on these cables again, and you see here to the back you've got that smooth surface. You don't have any holes there because I've worked that away. So now we're ready for row 6. Row 6, chain 1 and turn. Start with 5 double crochets, sorry, single crochets. On the first one, that's one, singles, one single, two, three, four, and five single crochets. We're now going to come down and work a front post treble around this first front post treble we have here. Around that one, twice over. You kind of have to fold your work just to really get around that stitch. So front post treble, pick up, and then complete the treble. And two. On the next two trebles, so that's going to be these two here, on those two, going to work a front post treble two together. So we're going to grab these two together. So that's twice over. Then around the first one, pick up your yarn, then take off two loops, take off two loops. Now stop. Yarn over twice, then around the next one, pick up your yarn, take off two loops, and take off two loops. At this point you have three loops on your hook. You're going to take all of them off in one go. Like so. And that was the treble two together, front post. Effectively we've now worked two stitches. That means we need to skip two stitches to the back. You can see I'm skipping those two and then working the next. Going to work a single crochet 1, 2 single crochets. And actually need to work a third one, sorry, so it's 3 single crochets. Okay. 3 single crochets, and now we're again going to work a front post treble around these two front posts we have here. That's twice over. Around the first one, again, kind of having to just fold my work just a little bit. And here you're going to work 2 full front post trebles. And 1, 2, and 3. So after these 2 front post trebles that we've just worked, we're going to work more front post trebles, and this time again around single crochets from 2 rows down. So this was the row of double crochets, and you've got here this row of single crochets. So around that row, going to work front post trebles, basically the same way that we did here. We're going to now do it there. And we're going to skip 2 single crochets on row 4, and now we just need to kind of check where they are, because you see here, this is kind of this position where we're currently at. See that position there? So you're going to skip that stitch. See, this is closest to the treble that you made. You see there's a treble, and that's the first single crochet, and that's the second one. So you're going to skip those 2, and then the third one, that one, I'm just going to mark that stitch. That's where we're going to be working the front post treble in. So you can see as you've skipped, there's a treble, and then 1, 2 single crochets, and then the third one going to work a treble, a front post treble. Around that stitch there. And just having a needle to hand to just really mark the place where you want that stitch, right? Might just be handy for you also. And then you can count, mark, and then work the stitch. That was the first front post treble. We're going to be doing 2, so also in the next stitch. Work a front post treble. Two, three. And again here you want to pay attention that this kind of all forms a straight line. I mean, it's not crisis if it's just a little bit up or down, but globally you want that to be a straight line on your stitches where you're currently at. Going to now skip 4 stitches to the back, because we've just worked these 2 trebles and we've now worked 2 new trebles, so we need to have 4 stitches in total. Let me just check, that's the last stitch work, and skip 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches, and then in the next one work a single. And this single is the first of 2, so only 2 single crochets. And 2. Everything we've now done, we're going to basically do again. We're going to make another set of front post trebles around the same single crochet from row 2 and the next stitch. So we're going to come down and work another one here. So this is very similar to what we've done there. So again, a front post treble. Now around the same position, it already has this treble here, around that same position, fold, pick up, and then 1, 2, 3. And the next one also, work another front post treble. So that's just really in the next stitch, that's not going anywhere else. So now you've worked 4 trebles, those descended 2 are in the same position and 1 on the outside. We're going to skip single crochets here to the bottom. So you see this is the last one worked, that's over there. See that stitch? Now we're going to skip 4 single crochets on this row. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Then stitch number 5, that's this one here, I'm just going to mark it. Going to work a front post treble around that single crochet. That's why it's really important to just mark this stitch, because that way I don't accidentally make mistakes. and also around the next one. Going to skip 4 stitches here to the back. Just check that. That's 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches skip, and then work a single. Going to work 2. And the front post treble around the same stitch from row 2. So here you've already have this one, going to work another one there. And another one there. So what I've now done, this is the same as that. So I've skipped, just walk through that again. So I've worked that last treble, then we've skipped 4 stitches here, mark the stitch, work the front post treble, worked another front post treble. To the back, skipped 4 stitches, work 2 single crochets, work a treble on the same position as you had the last one, and then work another treble in the position next to that. There's an awful lot of detail happening here, I realize that. After these 2, we're now going to continue and work on this side, basically the same we've did on that side. So first we're going to work 2 trebles around these stitches here. So around that first one, work a treble. And on the second one, work a treble. All front post, everything is front post. Going to skip 4 stitches to the back. 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches to the back. Let me just check how many single crochets we work on this side. 1, 2, 3 single crochets. Yes, so we work 3 here also. And now we're going to work a front post treble, 2 together around the first 2 here. So we've done those 3 single crochets. Now a front post, 2 together around these first 2. That's exactly the same as on the other side. You can see there's symmetry here in the middle on that side and this side. Twice over. Around the first one, take off 2 loops, 2 loops, twice over, second one, take off 2 loops, and 2 loops, 3 loops on your hook, take them all off. The last one needs a front post treble also. I'm going to skip 2 stitches to the back, and those are those 2, skipping 2 stitches to the back, and I work 5 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and number 5. Now, this was a difficult row, I'll give you that, and I do hope that you've managed to follow me along and see exactly where to make these, to make your stitches. What's important here is you're always going to work in the single crochets that are 2 rows down. So always keep that in mind. That's the place where you're going to be working these stitches. And these front posts, they're on the trebles we already have. For the next row, row 7, you're again going to work a row of double crochets. So it's a double crochet row here to the back. And to catch these pockets the way that I showed you before, so catch them again so you don't have them all loose, but have a nice sturdy fabric here to the back. So for row 7, work a row of double crochets, and I'll see you again for row 8. Row 8, chain 1. Just going to turn my work, have the front side facing. In this row we're going to be working a lot of front post double trebles. But first 7 single crochets on the first stitches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, seven single crochets. Going to come down and on the first treble here work a double treble. So that's three times over. Around that first stitch work a double treble for all front post. Everything was always front post here. Around the next one, that's going to be the double crochet two together. Also work a double treble. So one, two, three, four. Those are the first two stitches. Now what we're going to do is we're going to do a small repeat unit that we're going to do three times. We're going to skip these two trebles and then go to the next two. We're going to work double trebles on these two. Then we're going to come back and work on the two that we've skipped. First on these two here, work a double treble on both of those. Just three times over. On the first one, double treble. Again, give these stitches room to breathe. Three times over, and on the next one, so a double treble. At this point, we're going to skip four stitches to the back and then work two singles. Let me just check that we're skipping the correct number of stitches. So that's one, three, four skip. So that's actually one too many. Four stitches skip. One, two, three, four, and then work two singles. Two singles. Now we're going to come back and work a double treble on these two trebles that we've skipped. So those two there. First the one, two, that's the furthest away and then the closest one. Three times over, then come back, kind of fold your work to really get around that stitch. So one, two, three, four. And again, three times over and work one on the next one also. Two, three, and four. And this we're also now going to do here and here. So I'll show you again. At this point you'll see you have a big space here between, because you've skipped four stitches to the back. When you come back and you work your double crochets and you do decide to hook up those loops to the back, this will all be connected secure. So don't worry about this too much. I'm going to skip the next two trebles, as these two, and then go to those two. So we're first going to work a double treble on those two. And again, give these double trebles, give them room, because if you don't, your work is going to really scrunch inward and really pull inward. Two, three, four times. Three times over, and on the next one, going to come back. Sorry, first we're going to skip four stitches. Sorry, I forgot. One, two, three, four, skip. Skip four stitches to the back and work two singles. Two. You can see kind of how this is pulling inward, and this will all be fine when we work that next row of double crochets. That will kind of help to lift this all up a bit. And now on these two that we've skipped, going to work two front post doubles on those two. Come back. That's one, two, three, four. And on the next one also. One, two, three, as a second repeat, going to do it again. Going to skip these two and on those two trebles, work two front post double trebles. So that's one, two, three times over. do that again. Three times over, then around the first one. That's one, two, three, four. And on the second one, that's one, two, three, four. Skipping four stitches to the back. And let me just check. One, two, three, four. So over there. So do count these stitches, because otherwise everything will be warped if you skip too many or too few. Two single crochets, and then on the two that we've skipped, going to work two trebles on there. You can really see how your cables are taking shape, this 3D effect, that cables being stacked on top of one another. And that's really nice. Two, three. And the first one. This one, two, three, four. Three times over, and on that second one. See how I'm just kind of turning my work, and that could really help you just to make those stitches easier on yourself. Last time, on these last two, I'm going to work a front post. You need to work the repeat on this side also, of course. You need to do a front post double treble around the treble two together and around the last stitch here also. So around those two, going to do a front post double treble. Three times over. Everything is double treble here. Never mind what I just said. Double trebles. So that's around that double crochet two together, the treble two together, and around this treble work a double treble. Two, three, four. I'm going to skip four stitches to the back. That's one, two, three, four. Skip and work a single, and that should be the first of seven. Two, three, four, five, six, and the last one here is on position number seven. That's the last one there. And your cables are really starting to take shape. This is what your square looks like at the moment. You can see these cables there that are crossing. So now you're going to come back and work that row of double crochets again. And when you do so, I really do suggest you catch these stitches here, that you don't have these pockets there. But come back and work a row of double crochets. Row 10, chain 1. Turn to have the front side facing. Then 6 single crochets. One, two, three. Was it three? One, two, three. Oh, that's four. I keep losing it. Five and six. Six single crochets. Let me just check. One, two, three, four, five, six. Yes, yeah, six single crochets. I'm going to skip these first two trebles worked, and we're going to work in the next two, so those two there, and we're going to do a double treble around them. So around that first one, it's one, two, three, four, and one, two, around that next one also, two, three. Oh dear, I think I had four times over there. I just need three times over. One, two, three times over. And then take off one, two, three, four times. That's the first two stitches. After these two trebles, we're going to skip two stitches to the back. One, two, skip. Skipping two stitches to the back, and work two singles. One and two. And now we can start our repeat units. What we're going to do is we're going to work double trebles around these two here on the outside, but we're going to do that by working underneath the stitches we just made. So actually, so underneath that space, kind of push our hook in from this side here and then grab those stitches there. So that's why we're going to work these double trebles, and then we're going to come to this side and work these trebles here, skipping those and then coming back underneath and working them. So that's what we're going to be doing in this row. So let's first work those first two double trebles underneath this space here, so underneath there. I'm going to do three times over, two, three, and then lifting this up, go underneath and hook onto that first stitch. I'm actually just going to fold and just push this forward so I can really get to that stitch underneath there, and then take off four times. One, two, three, four. And that was the first one. You need to do it on both. So three times over, and then underneath, look for that double treble there. Onto your double treble and take off. One, two, three, four times. And I'm just going to lie it flat now, and then you can just see how you've now worked underneath that. So those first two are over the last two. That's exactly what you want. You're really going to have to go underneath here and grab those stitches. You really have to fold your work and turn your work to get that to an easy angle for you. So after these first two, you're going to skip the next two trebles. That's going to be these two, and then work two double trebles on those two. So we're now going to work there. Let's get three times over. Work a double treble. One, two, three, four. Three times over, and the next one. That's one, two, three. And we do that again. One, two, three, four. Going to skip four stitches to the back. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. Skipping four stitches to the back. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then work two single crochets. One and two. And that was the repeat unit. Now we're going to do everything again. Next one is again here working on these two trebles that we've skipped. These we're working underneath, so in that space there. So again, three times over for the double treble, and then digging up that first stitch. There are the stitches. So I'm digging up that first one, a treble on it. I'm really turning my work so it's at an easier angle for me. And then that second one. And after you've worked it, you can kind of fashion it all back into shape again. And four. And if I bring it back up, then it falls neatly into place. I'm going to skip these two and go to the next two. So there's those two there. Again, one, two, three times. So one, two, three, four. One, two, three. So one, two, three, four. Skipping four stitches to the back, work two singles. One, two, three, four. Skip. Work two single crochets. One, two. That was the second time repeat. Again, going to come down and work these two that we've skipped underneath the space there. One, two, three. Turning my work, gonna just dig up that stitch. two, four, and also on the next one, so one, two, right, yeah, because there's just so many loops, I mean it just does a, and you want to give your stitches room to breathe, that means you're not working too tight, and then sometimes I just slip off my hook. And then again, that was the next one. And see how I'm just bringing them back into shape after making those stitches. Going to work them on these last two. Going to work two double trebles on those two. One, two, three. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Sorry, only three times over. You take them all four times. You take, but you do only three times over. One, two, three, four times. You take off two loops. Skipping four stitches to the back. One, two, three, four. Work two singles. The last part of this row, we're going to come back and work on these two that we skipped. Underneath again, so I'm turning my work just to really be able to get underneath these stitches. One, two, three, four, and the last one there. Skipping two stitches to the back, one, two, skip. Skipping two stitches, need to work six singles. One, two, three, four, five, and six. That completes row 10. I mean, your overlay here is really getting nice and thick. So row 11, come back and work double crochets on every stitch, and then you'll also be able to fix this these gaps that you have here. So come back and work a row of double crochets. Row 12, chain one, and turn, have the front side of your work facing. Going to work four single crochets. Two, three, four single crochets. Going to come down and work a front post double treble around the first two. So these two we have here around those two. It's one, two, three times over. Around the first one, work a double treble. Let's do that again. Let's do that again. One, two, three, four. There we go. And around the next one also. Remember to give your stitches room to breathe. First two, do a front post double treble. Going to skip two stitches to the back, skipping two stitches, then work three singles. One, two, and three. Now I'm going to start a repeat unit. We're going to skip the next two trebles, those, that's these two here, and then going to work on those two. We're going to work a front post double trebles on those two. Three times over. First one, two, three, four, and then the second one, two, three, four. You're going to skip two stitches to the back and then work two single crochets. Okay, let me just check. Yeah, one, two stitches skip, and then work 2 single crochets. I'm going to come back and work a front post double treble around those 2 stitches that we skipped. These 2 in here, those 2 there. I'm just going to turn my work just to be able to get in there around them easily. So don't feel scared about turning your work and having it at all kinds of angles, just to make life easy for yourself. And then work a double treble around both of those. And that's going to fall over the stitches you just made. So here it was underneath, and now it's going over. You can see the pattern is building. Those were the 2 on the ones that we skipped. Now we're going to skip again 2 front post double trebles, and that's going to be these 2 here. They're slightly hidden by this. We're going to skip those 2 and go to these 2 here on the next side. So again, 3 times over. And then 1, 2, 3, 4. Again on the next one. 1, 2, 3, 4. You have to skip 4 stitches to the back because you've got these 2 and those 2. You're going to skip 4 stitches, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4 skip. That's one, that one. See, I'm skipping 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches. Then work 2 single crochets. And we're going to do that again. So on in here, work a double treble on those 2. Again, turning my work to really get around that stitch that we skipped. And what you're doing is you're building stitches over and under, and that's kind of forming this this knot here, this Celtic knot. There we go. Going to skip the next 2 again, so that these 2, and then go to those 2, working a front post double treble around that. 3. So it's the same rhythm, over and under. And take your time on these stitches, because you want them to lie flat on your work. They're not too short or too long. I'm going to skip 4 stitches to the back again. That's 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches skip. Skipping 4 stitches, work 2 singles. 2. Going to again work a front post double treble around the 2 that we skipped here. Around that one there. Again, you see how I've turned my work just to make it easy for myself. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Skipping 4 stitches. Now we're going to work skipping 2 stitches and then work 3 single crochets. It was just for a moment, I was slightly confused. Skipping 2 stitches, 1, 2, work 3 single crochets. 1, 2, 3 single crochets. On these last 2 here, work a front post double treble on both of them also. And 2. Skip 2 stitches to the back, your last, those 2 stitches, and And the last stitch, you're going to make four singles. 1, 2, 3. I do believe that I've skipped one stitch too few. I didn't stitch because I've got one stitch left. That's 1, 2, 3, and 4. There we go. That is your row 12 already. I'm going to come back on row 13 and work a double crochet on every stitch. And then in the next row we can build on these waves again. Row 14, chain 1, turn to have the front of your work facing. I'm going to do 4 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4. Around these first 2 front post double trebles, we're going to do a front post treble note. We're going to do 2 trebles. We've been doing a lot of double trebles, so you might go autopilot here. So be mindful, only twice over we're doing a treble around the first one. And a treble around the second one. You would be forgiven for going autopilot here and doing a double treble, but then this loop will be just a little bit too large. Skipping the next 2 stitches, work 4 singles. So skipping 2 stitches, work 4 singles. So that's 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 singles. Going to come down and work a front post treble around each of these 2 double trebles below here. So those 2 there, those 2. Work a front post treble. So it's again twice over only. Work again a front post treble. 1, 2, 3. And again 1, 2, and 3. Going to skip 2 stitches to the back. Oh, no, sorry, we're going to skip these 2 trebles here and work those 2. So what we're going to do now is we're going to be continuing our knot. So these 2 here, we're going to skip those and work a double treble around those 2 there. That's what we're now going to do. It's twice, it's 3 times over. Around the first one. So you're making a long stitch here again. 1, 2, 3 times over. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we're going to skip stitches to the back, 4 stitches to be exact. 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches. And work 1, 2 single crochets. We're now going to come back and work a front post double treble around these 2 stitches that we skipped, but we're again going to do it underneath. So underneath those 2, we're going to work these 2 here. So you're again going to have to fold your work the way we did before. So it's going to be 3 times. And underneath here, I'm going to hook up that stitch, just bring it all up. 1, 2, 3, 4. And the same for the one next to it, of course. That would be there. 1, 2, 3, 4. And you can just fashion everything a little bit into shape. You've worked those 2 underneath. I'm going to skip again the next front post treble. It's this one here. And then work 2 trebles around that one there. So these 2. And then we're going to come back here. So the next two we're skipping, and those two are the front post double treble. So one, two, three, four times, take off two loops, and then again, one, two, three. One, two, three, four. Skipping four stitches to the back. One, two, three, four stitches skip. Yes, is that correct? One, two, three, four. Yes, four stitches skip. Work two singles. Now again, working a front post double treble underneath here. So we're going to do this again. Underneath, work on those two there. And I'll hook up that stitch, bring it upwards. One, two, three, four, one, two, three. And at last, double treble. One, two, three, four. There you go. And again, you just fold everything back and into position. Going to work on these next we're going to work a front post treble around these next two double trebles here. So again, to be only a treble, so that's twice over. Next one also. One, two, three. To skip four stitches to the back. It's one, two, three, four, skip. And then work one, two, four single crochets. Two, three, four single crochets. The last two trebles you have here, work a front post treble around those also. Two, two, three, and then that last one. You just skip two stitches to the back, the last two stitches, one, two. Then you should have four stitches left. Work a single crochet on each of those. There you go. That completes row 12. No, 14 already. Row 14. Row 15 is again a row of double crochets where you can catch these trebles if you want to and connect everything to your work. Row 16. Chain one, make sure you have the front side facing, four single crochets. So one, two, three, four single crochets. I'm going to come down and work a front post treble around these two trebles you already have here. It's twice over. And then the next one, one, two, three. I'm going to skip two stitches to the back and then work three singles. Two and three. I'm going to now skip the next two front post trebles, those are those two, and work on these two here, the ones that are on top. We're going to work on those two. Work a front post double treble, so it's three times over. One, two, three, four, and again on the next one, three times over, three times over, and hook up and take all four loops. One, two, two, three, four times. I'm going to skip the next two stitches and work two single crochets. So skipping those two to the back, work two singles. And two. Mega. Going to work two front post double trebles around this two that we skipped here. I'm folding my work to really get around those stitches. Turn your work if needed. Three times over, and then next one also. One, two, three, and four. And these are again on top. You can really see how your knot is taking shape here. Work those first two. Going to skip these two trebles here and go to those two that are on top. Work two front post double trebles on there. Two, three, four, two, three. And on the next one also. One, two, three, four. Going to skip four stitches to the back. One, two, three, four, skip. One, two, three, four. It's four stitches, skip. Then work two single crochets. And we're again going to work on these two that we skipped down here. We're going to work a front post double treble on those. Folding to get around and under. One, two, three, four. And again. One, two, three, and four. So the first two, now we're again going to skip these two here, and on those two work two front post double trebles on those. One, two, three, four, and again. Skip four stitches to the back. One, two, three. One, two, three, four stitches to the back and work two singles. Two front post double trebles around those two inside there. One, two, three. You can really start feeling the rhythm of the pattern. Over and under and skipping and then working and then coming back, and that way you're weaving your pattern. One, two, three, four. There you go. Going to skip those two stitches that we just worked to the back. One, two, skip, and then work three singles. Two front post trebles around these two trebles here. So that's one, and two. Skipping two stitches to the back, four single crochets to the end. Three, and on the last one, four. Complete row 16, work a row of double crochets again. Row 18, chain one, and work six single crochets. Two, three, 4, 5, and 6. I'm going to work front post double treble around these two trebles here. Double treble, 1, 2, 3 times over, around the first one, 2, 3, 4 times, 3 times over, and this next one, 2, 3, and 4. Skipping 2 stitches to the back, work 2 single crochets. Skipping 2 stitches, yep, 1, 2, work 2 singles, and 2. Going to work 1 treble on each of these 2 double trebles down here. So take note, this is a treble, so only twice over. Going to skip these front post double trebles, and on the next two, these two here, work 2 double trebles. So on those next two, up, 2, 3, 4, and on the next one also, 2, 3, 4. And to skip 4 stitches to the back, 1, 2, 3, 4 skip, then work 2 singles. 2. Going to now work on the 2 stitches that we skipped, and we're again going to do that underneath the stitches that we just did. So underneath those, this one to work on those 2. So again, a double treble. Turning my work underneath, grab that first loop, then bring everything up, and that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and the next one also. That, and then fashion that, then you see how your 2 loops are over the ones that you just made. Going to skip the next 2, these 2, and then go onto those 2 and work here 2 double trebles again. It's the same rhythm. The rows aren't exactly repeating, but it is very similar, the type of stitches that you're making from one row to the next. Skipping 4 stitches to the back, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4 skip. 4 stitches skip, work 2 singles. 2 singles. Again, a front post double treble around the 2 that we skipped, working underneath the last 2 stitches that we made. Hook up on that treble, bring forward, and then that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the next one is 1, 2, 3. Skipping, yes, there we go. Now we're not skipping any stitches yet. We first need to work these 2 front post trebles around here. That's twice over. The first one. And this second one. So those were two trebles. Now skipping 4 stitches to the back, 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches skip, 1, 2, 3, 4, yes, work 2 singles, 2, front post double treble around these 2 here, last 2 for this row, 2, 3, 4, to skip 2 stitches to the back, 1, 2 skip, and then work 6 single crochets. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and on the last one is number 6. Completes row 18. Come back and work a row of double crochets. Row 20, chain 1, have the front of your square facing, and then work 7 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Single crochets. Let's work a front post double treble around these 2 double trebles we already have. It's 1, 2, 3 times over. Very similar to everything we've done before. 1, 2, 3, 4. And again 3 times over and working a double treble on the next one. And 4. We're going to skip the next 2 front post trebles, so that's these 2. We're going to skip those and then work a front post double treble around the other 2, so those 2 that are up top here. That's 1, 2, 3 times over. Skipping those 2 on the next. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3 times over, and then work another double treble. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And there we go. I just skip 4 stitches and then work 2 singles. So skipping 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches skip, work 2 single crochets. 1, 2. There we go. Going to do a front post double treble around the 2 stitches that we skipped. So on those 2 there, do a front post treble. I'm going to turn my work, get really around those stitches that we skipped, work 2 front post double trebles. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, and 4. There we go. Going to skip the next 2 stitches and then work a front post double treble on those 2. So you're going to do the same as what we just did. 3 times over, and that's 1 and the second. Skipping 4 stitches to the back, work 2 singles. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches skip, and work 1, 2 single crochets. Again, work a double treble on the 2 stitches that we skipped. That's 1, next. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Omega. First two, and then we're going to skip these two trebles here, and on those two, work front post double treble. 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Going to skip 4 stitches to the back again. It's 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches skip. Work 2 singles, 1 and 2. Last time, this one here, those 2 stitches work a front post double treble around those. 1, 2, 3. And that one. So 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. And then a double treble around the last 2 you've got on this side. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3 times over. The squares are really starting to grow. 4, skipping 4 stitches again. It's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. One more. 4 stitches skip. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, correct. And then this is the first of 7 single crochets. It's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the last one here, number 7. Come back and work your row of double crochets for row 21. Row 22. You have to chain 1 and turn so you have the right side facing. Start with 5 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 single crochets. Going to skip the first set of trebles and then go to the next set, these two here. Going to work a front post double treble around those 3 times over. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, and again 1, 2, 3, and 4. You just skip 2 stitches to the back and then work 3 single crochets. So I'm skipping 2 stitches and then work 3 single crochets. We're now going to go underneath the stitches we just worked to work on the trebles underneath, so with a double treble, so just like we've done before. I'm just going to turn my work, so 1, 2, 3 times over, then underneath, grabbing that stitch there, bring it up, and then make a double treble. Again, there it is, and a double treble. Turn my work back, just fashion those cables a bit. I'm going to skip the next set of cables, that's these two, and go to those two front post, to those double trebles. I'm going to work a double treble on that. again 4 times and the next one. Going to skip 4 stitches to the back, 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches skip, then work 2 singles. Going to do all of this again. Going to start by working underneath here on those 2 trebles. 3 times over, underneath, grabbing that treble. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and again. To skip the next series of trebles, these 2, and then work a double treble on those 2. 2, 3 times over. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And on the next one also. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Skipping 4 stitches to the back. It's 1, 2, 3, 4 skips. It's 1 too many. Skipping 4 stitches, work 2 single crochets. Just done it 2 times. Going to do the repeat 1 more time, so 3 times in total. So again, double treble underneath here, grabbing that stitch there, bringing it up front. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. Again on the next one, and that's 1, 2, 3, and 4. On my last one here, work a double treble on there. Skipping 4 stitches to the back, 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches skip, work 2 single crochets. Going to work a third single crochet, so that's 3, so 1 extra. Now we're going to come underneath and work a treble on these last 2 trebles here, so here underneath on those last 2. 1, 2, 3 times over. Underneath, grabbing a hold of that treble, which I'm having trouble finding. Ah, here it is, on the treble. Bring it up front. And 1, 2, 3, 4, and the next one, also the one next to it. To skip 2 stitches to the back, skip 2 stitches to the back, and now work 5 single crochets. That should bring you to the end of this row. And the last one, number 5, on that last stitch. There we go. That was row 22 already. Come back and work row 23, all double crochet stitches. Row 24, to do a chain 1. I have the right side facing again. Work 3 single crochets. 1, 2, 3 single crochets. The front post double treble around the first bar here, the first double treble. 1, 2, 3. Around that first one, make a double treble. Now you've got an option. We're going to work 2 stitches around the next stitch. You can either work 2 double trebles around the same post, so one and then another one, or work a double treble and a treble, and I'm going to do that second option. So that's 3 times over, and work a double treble around that post. And 4. So what you could do now is, again, 3 times over, and around the post, pick up, and work a double treble. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to work a treble, and I'm going to work at the bottom of this stitch. So in that little loop there, I'm going to place it there. The reason is then the stitch becomes neater. So twice over, in the bottom of this stitch, in that opening, just going to hook up and work the treble. And this is a matter of choice, what you do. I prefer this because this is just slightly neater. So I've worked it there in the bottom of the double treble that I just made. I'm going to skip 3 stitches to the back and then work 3 single crochets. So you're going to skip 1, 2, 3 stitches and then work 3 singles. 1, 2, and 3 single crochets. You're going to skip the next 2 trebles, that's these 2, and then work a double treble around the 2 after that, so that's those 2. Around here, work a double treble. 2, 3, 4, 4. And around the next one also. 2, 3, and 4. Going to come back. We're going to skip 2 stitches to the back. And then work 2 single crochets, so skipping, see, oh, that's too many, there we go, skipping 2 stitches to the back, work 2 single crochets. Now we're going to come back and work a double treble on the 2 that we've skipped. That's 1, 2, 3 times over, and then over, working over them, sorry, not under them, over the 2 that we've skipped. 3 and 4. 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, and 4. There we go. So those 2 you've worked on top. We're now again going to skip 2 stitches, those 2 trebles, and then go to these 2 trebles and work a double treble on both of those. 1, 2, 3, 4, and again, double treble on the next one. 1, 2, 3, 4. Going to skip 4 stitches to the back and then work 2 singles. So 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches skip and then work 2 single crochets. Repeating, that means again on the 2 that we've skipped, work a double treble on both of those from the top. 4, and also on the next one. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. There we go. Skipping these 2 trebles down here. On that one, again, work 2 double trebles. Oops, again, 3 times over. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Skipping 4 stitches to the back. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches. Skip, yes. Work 2 single crochets. Now again, a front post double treble around the 2 stitches that we've skipped. Again, 3 times over. There are the 2 that we skipped. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and again. Slowly but surely you're getting towards the end of this square. We have a lot of very interesting cables at this point. You're going to skip 2 stitches to the back and then work 3 single crochets. Let me just check. I'm going to skip 1, 2 stitches and then in the third. So 1, 2, 3 single crochets. At this point we're going to again work the 2 double trebles around the same stitch, and I'm going to do it in the same way I did over there. So I'm going to work a double treble and treble. So I'm going to work a double treble. 2, 3, 4. So what you can do now is again work a double treble around there. I'm going to do a treble, so it's only twice over. Then into the bottom of the stitch, that bottom loop, going to work a treble. And that's purely because I find it's a bit neater. Then 3 times over, and on the next one work a double treble again. 3. Skip 3 stitches to the back because we now work 3 stitches. 1, 2, 3. And then on the last stitches work 3 single crochets. And 3. At this point you've worked row 24. Come back, work a double crochet on every stitch. Row 26. Chain 1. Have the right side facing. And then work 5 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We're going to work 2 front post double trebles around the first 2 stitches here. It's going to be 1, 2, 3. Also on the next one, front post, double treble. There we go. I'm going to work a front post double treble 2 together, it's quite a mouthful, around this loop, this front post treble, and that one. So between these 2, I'm going to work a treble 2 together. Double treble, so it's 1, 2, 3, and around this first post, then take off 2, take off 2, take off 2, now you stop, 1, 2, 3 again, and then go to this next loop, it's that one there, and take off 2, take off 2, take off 2, go 3 loops on your hook. Take them all off. You've got 1 treble left over there. I'm going to work a double treble on that. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. We've now worked, in essence, we've worked 4 stitches. going to skip 4 stitches to the back. It's 1, 2, 3, 4 skip. And this single crochet is the first of 18. That's 2, 3, 4, 17. 18. So I've now worked 18 single crochets. Brings me almost to the other side. On the last 5 trebles, we're going to be working. So not those two. You're going to leave all of that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. On those, you're going to work. On the first of the 5, so from my working side, I'm going to do a double treble. And then 1, 2, 3, 4 times. On the next 2, do a double treble 2 together. So it's going to be the leg over here and that one over there. Bring those 2 together. 1, 2, 3 times over. This one. Take off 2 loops. Take off 2. Take off 2. And stop with 2 loops on your hook. 3 times over on the next one. And then again, take off 2, take off 2, take off 2. 3 loops on your hook, take them all off. You've got 2 left, going to work a double treble on each of those. 1, 2, 3, and on the last one. 1, 2, 3, and 4. I'm going to skip 4 stitches to the back. Skipping 1, 2, 3, 4, so that's a stitch too many. 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches skip. And I work single crochet to the end. That's 5, 2, 3, 4, and the last one, number 5. Complete row 26. Going to come back and work a double crochet on every stitch for row 27. We've now completed the square and we're going to be making an edge around the square. Chain 1. Then in the first stitch, that first one, they're going to work 3 single crochets. And this is your new corner. 3 single crochets. Continue and along the edge, work 34 single crochets. It's going to bring you almost to the other side. And then in the last stitch, we're going to work a corner again. 34 single crochets along this edge. See how you're building this edge. So 34 along here. And then this is number 34. At this point, you're going to have 1 stitch left, that last stitch there. In there, work 3 single crochets again. That's a new corner. And 3 single crochets. Turn again, and now you're here on the edge, and along this edge you're again going to space 34 single crochets, and you're kind of going to have to eyeball them to get them evenly distributed, because you want 34 evenly distributed single crochets. And you can just punch your hook in there and then work the single crochet. Because it's all in the same color, you won't notice any irregularities. It's going to be very forgiving. So I'm just going to work 34 stitches here, and you're just going to have to just eyeball them a little bit, exactly where you want them, where you need them, to make sure there are no any big gaps where there are no stitches, and that there are also not too many stitches close together. So work 34 along this edge. Thing going to happen, you're going to come to the corner here, and I'll just quickly show you the part here also. So work 34 until you're on this point here. That's 34 stitches along this edge. Now you're at the bottom and you've got the foundation chain. See that's those stitches there. And then in the corner, especially that first one, it's going to be just a little bit hard, but that first one, work 3 single crochets in the corner. That's a new corner made. And now on the bottom of the chains, you can see those little V's because you worked in the spine. In the bottom of those stitches, work a single crochet on each. That's going to be again 34 single crochets. I'm going to bring you to the other side, to the next corner. There again, work 3 single crochets in the corner. So continue here, working until you get to this last point here. I'm going to work 3 in the corner. And turn and work 34 evenly spread along this side also. When you get to this point here, close on your first stitch. When you finish, you've gone all the way around, work away your yarn tails. This is what your square looks like. You can see the lovely knotted cable design on your square. You'll notice it's a bit wonky, it's all bobbly and everything, so take a moment to block your square to just flatten it out and get it nicely into shape. And after blocking, your square looks like this. Your edges are much straighter and that bobble is all gone. Brings us to the end of this instruction video. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you again for a new project.